Something brand new and on the fly there. Steve Aoki back at it again together with Marnik and Lil Jon. The song this time is called Supernova. The same guys who brought you the song Pern definitely out of this world. Another thing I'd like to let you guys know is an out of this world superstar is just inside the booth as we speak. So if you guys are watching us via the live stream 979homeradio.com, you are in for a special treat. Everyone, I'm very excited to let you guys in on what's happening at the booth at the moment. She is here to promote a new album. You want to know who she is? Log in to Facebook 979 Home Radio and keep us company. Again, the text lines are up and running, 0925-501-5658. So without further ado, let me introduce to you Oprah Winfrey's dubbed as the most talented girl in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, here she is, Miss Charice Bambanko.
Hey.
Wow, looking great, and of course, I'm dumbing fast.
I haven't noticed outside.
I know, there's like about 50 people hanging outside waiting for you. So ladies and gentlemen, Charice is in the house, and we're going to talk to her about her new album called Catharsis.
Yep,
Catharsis. Okay, so tell me a little something about the album. Why is it called Catharsis?
My goal, we made goal for this album, for everybody to release their emotions, and then sa lahat ng kanta na maririnig nila, if you listen to all the songs from the album, iba't-ibang emotions, merong happy, merong para sa mga martir.
Nako!
para sa mga nasaktan, sa mga umiibig, sa lahat, different emotions. So I guess, masasabi ko na kaya catharsis kasi each song na maririnig niya sa album has a cathartic feeling in it. You know, like when they listen to it, they're gonna be able to release the emotions, strong emotions na meron sila inside them.
So definitely a nostalgic feeling in every track from Catharsis by Charice. Now let me ask you another question. By the looks of this album, it seems like it's a brand new genre. It's a brand new Charice that we're all going to be witnessing. Charice, tell us why you kind of shifted, or why you decided to shift from the pop industry to the pop scene, from the pop scene into the rock kind of music.
I think I'd call the genre indie.
Kasi indie, okay.
Actually, hindi siya yung pinilit na I just
Sama.
You know, parang I wrote the songs kasi gusto ko maging katunog siya nito, or because I'm a fan of Kurt Cobain, or I'm a fan of Sonic Youth or whatever. It's not about they are my inspirations for the album, but. But really, when I was writing the songs, parang lumabas na eh. Kaya actually, kaya naging iba-iba yung feel ng songs. Merong punk, merong alternative, merong parang medyo may boost ng konti. So, I guess nung nasabi sa akin na, you know, after yung album, makinalabasan niya. Kasi iniisip ko, baka lahat maging alternative, lahat maging ganito, ganyan. And then, ang parang naging result is halo-halo siya, which na-realize ko, very indie. So parang sabi ko, I guess I am meant to this kind of genre kasi I just let it happen eh.
Okay.
I just wrote everything and made the arrangement with the help of mayonnaise. And it all happened. And it turned out to sound like an indie rock album. So I'm very happy na yun yung kinilabasan niya.
Of course. So basically what you're trying to say is may kanya-kanyang calling per track. So iba-iba yung hugot from the singles. And you guys have to find out more about this. You guys got to check out the album, Catharsis. Okay, a follow-up question. Since you mentioned Monty from Mayonnaise, I believe. Let me in on how you met Monty from the get-go. Ano ba kayo nagkakilala? How did you end up collaborating with each other? Kasi ganito yan eh. Charice Bambanko eh, no? Tapos biglang Mayonnaise. Nakilala niya si Mayonnaise. It's Monty, of course. The genius from the rock industry in the Philippines. How did you guys kind of collaborate or meet?
Well, we met at a dinner and then we just started talking. Nag-open ako sa kanya about nasabi ko na some of my inspiration, mga banda na nagbago that turned my life, you know, into something more interesting.
Okay.
And then, kinuwento ko sa kanya na when I discovered the music career and all the music of Kurt, I was like, oh, you know, this is amazing. His music actually pushed me to write my own songs. I was scared, like years ago. Everybody was asking me to write my own music, but I couldn't. And finally, someone else's music made me realize that I can do it. So sabi yun, kasi nakarelate kami dalawa, huwag na click yung relationship namin dalawa as my mentor and the mentee, you know? So, yun, sinabi niya, nagkwento siya na actually same, kasi parang dahil kaya nabuo din ang Mayonis kasi fan, sobrang fan din siya ng Nirvana. So sabi ko, parang doon kami na gano'n na sinuportahan niya yung goal ko and sinuportahan niya yung dream ko to do what I really want in my life. And when we started working together, pinarinig ko sa kanya mga arrangements ko, binigyan nila ng buhay, and everything just, ano mo yun, fell into the right places. And sabi niya na parang talagang
so parang it's a perfect meeting, kumbaga. It's really meant to be.
It was.
I love it. So is it safe to say that Monty and you kind of share the same interest with the artists and the music that you guys both like?
Siyempre, magkaiba, but I mean, if you still listen to both of our, sobrang magkaiba,
okay.
Pero yung way, alam mo yun, yung way, and yung paano namin na-discover yung music na talagang gusto namin, halos pa rin.
Right, so yung atake, kumbaga.
Yung mas lalo na-inspired kasi, lalo kay Sir Mons, kasi yung pinagdaanan din niya, and yung kung paano nabuo yung banda niya, dun ako na-inspired.
Amazing. So, you know, it was a perfect meeting and a perfect time with the perfect people, so to speak.
Yes,
I love it. Okay, so since you said this is your first time, if I'm not mistaken, to write your own music?
Yes, I do.
So what inspired you, basically, to kind of pursue this? Na parang ikaw na dapat yung magsusulat ng mga sarili mong music from the get-go, from before, di ba meron mga collaborators?
Mm-hmm.
So ngayon, it's really basically just a position of who you really are. You really want to let the audience know who you are in a deeper level, kaya ka nagsulat ng songs. So tell us a little more about this. Paano ka nagsimula magsulat ng sarili mong mga music?
It was actually, it was just an interesting day because my brother and I are gamers.
Okay.
And then one time we were playing this game, and then I just heard this song from David Bowie, The Man Who Sold the World.
Ooh, nice, okay.
Yes, and then, I don't know, for some reason, when I heard it, it's like, astig nito, gano'n, parang, so I looked it up on YouTube and I realized that there's a Nirvana a cover.
Wow.
So when I listened to Kurt's version of it, it made me fall in love
even more with the way
he did it. You know, I mean, I love David Bowie, but personally, it was just different. And then I started listening to his other songs. His other songs, not just the songs from the Bleach, which is it, or the Nevermind
okay.
album, you know. I started listening to his In Utero, the Incesticide album.
So legitimately, like true fan ka talaga ng Nirvana.
Oh, no, don't go to my house because I have a Kurt Cobain shrine there.
Oh my god,
yes,
I love it!
Yeah.
So what if Kurt Cobain, okay, let me give you a follow-up question. So if Kurt Cobain, if you have the chance to actually collaborate with Kurt Cobain, what kind of music would
don't
you want?
Do that. Well, I guess I'd love for it would have been really awesome because from all of his albums, one of my favorites. I'd like to make one kind of like a Penner Royalty kind of feel song from him or something in the way. And another one is his song called School or Aneurysm. You know, one that really makes you like a heavy,
so like
heavy arrangement,
like heavy
and
metal.
One with just a chill arrangement, like All Apologies, you know, something like that. And, but you know,
I love it.
Yeah,
I love how you're like passionately into the music here,
yes.
And you really get to know more about Charice, of course, through the album. A follow-up question: we all know Charice has been in the industry for quite a while. And of course, as dubbed by Oprah Winfrey, ikaw nga daw yung the most talented girl in the world that she's ever met. So how does it feel to be in the industry for so long from the music industry onto the acting. Oh my god, can I just say, I'm such a huge fan of Sunshine Corazon. I'm a huge fan of that. For those who don't know, I'm a Glee fanatic. And see, Charice was actually part of that, and she's the first Asian, okay, to reach the top, the Billboard hit chart. How does that make you feel? Now, in the industry for so long, and already at your peak point, and pataas pa na pataas.
I don't know. I always feel. I don't know what to feel. Actually, okay. When people like tell me, you're the first Asian to be.
Right.
It makes me feel happy. It makes me feel happy. Okay. Don't get me wrong. It's just sometimes, I get shy and all that. I get awkward about it. But of course, it makes me feel proud to be able to represent. Our country. And second of all, with everything that happened. My life has been 10 years. I mean, the career, music career-wise, it's been 10 years, and hindi lang music, hindi lang yung lahat ng achievements, but all the struggles that happened in my life too, the struggles, the challenges that happened in my life, sometimes it makes me think, I can't believe that those happened, and I survived. You know, I guess masarap na feeling sila how when you think about it.
Oh, right.
When after all those achievements and all those happy moments, that there were times na talagang some situation brought me down, but I survived it. Those are the best achievements, I can say. Na talagang nangyari sa
mga. Tama. And with those achievements come great music. And these are what inspired you to write amazing songs. So, ladies and gentlemen, with that being said, again, Charice's new album is out called Catharsis, where you can get to know more about who she really is, who she has turned into, and what she has evolved from. Ladies and gentlemen, Charice, I'm going to play you guys this, the Carrier track, Killing Myself to Sleep, just a short while. For now, though, I'd like you to invite everybody to maybe buy the album, which is available now, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, my album Catharsis Under Star Music is now available in all online stores worldwide. At mapapakinggan niyo po na natin ang Carrier single and also composed by me na Killing Myself to Sleep. And soon it will be available in all record bars nationwide. Also, don't forget to request my song here at Home Radio 97.9. And stay tuned to Star Music social networking sites for more updates. And you can also follow me at my Instagram at charice.92, Facebook Team Charice, and on Twitter at official Charice. And also, I'll see you guys this November in Davao and Iloilo, and I'll be in Indonesia and Hong Kong this December. So thank you so much, Chester. I love you guys. I love you, everybody, for thank you for supporting the album so far. So
brand new Charice for this album called Catharsis. I love it. And we are going to get to hear the first or the Carrier single for said album in just a short while. Again, thank you so much, Charice,
for
being here.
Me.
I appreciate all the love. And of course, nakaka-inspire
you.
You guys can all feel the same way with this track called Killing Myself to Sleep. Keep it locked in. This is the music of now. 97.9 Home Radio. I love it. Thank you so much.
Have a okay.
Sure. Too ugly here. Say hi to all the homies who are listening.
Hi, everybody.
Hey, it's Charice! I'm gonna say hi to you.
Hi,
y'all. This is good. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's not right. Get out of here. Cheers to Patrick. Thank you so much.
Make it DJ, man.
All right.
Did that just happen? Oh my god. Guys, you have no idea how nervous I was. Oh my god, my hands were kind of shaking. I hope that was alright. Oh
my god. Thank you so much.
Probably. She has such a presence. It's crazy. I don't know why.
She has like a little aura.
Jim, ikaw yun, diba?
There you have it, from her album called Catharsis, Charice with the Carrier single called Killing Myself to Sleep. As we get to know more about Charice, tune in for more updates on her personal pages. You guys can check that out on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. For now, we gotta go back to the music that you want to hear, requested right off the bat from the text line 0925-501-5658. Post Malone and Justin Bieber, Deja Vu on Home Radio.
Cause I can't take
it home. Woo! Wala siyang PR.
Nasa kanya na.
Pero wala rin.
Kinuha na rin nila.
Ay, pinalipin.
Walang iniwan sa akin, wala.
Tinawag ako ni Mayor.
Ano sabi?
Oh, yung tao mo kulang ha.
Parang tao?
Social media. Butas yung tao mo. Buha ka pa ng isang tao. Yes.
Maghahanap ka pa.
Isang writer ba?
Kulang na kulang mga tao sa tao. Wala na po si Charice.
Sorry, ano yung single
niya? Killing Myself to Sleep. Yun yung Carrier. Catharsis. To sleep, ah. Catharsis. Own direction. Woo! Okay, so we're gonna go back to the music. Once I get this shit settled. Fuck. Okay, hold on. Sorry. Oh my god, it's falling. Oy. Okay, put it in. Cause you want me and I want you. You alone,
right. Thank you, guys.
Friends out there on air.
Hey.
We are the home of the millennials. Many 7.9 home radio. Think Before You Post, a social media responsibility reminder brought to you by 97.9 Home Radio. Everyone experiences stress at work. Instead of announcing your stress online, do something about it by investing on your hobbies or trying something new. Think Before You Post, a social media responsibility reminder brought to you by 97.9 Home Radio.